I did. All right, we'll stop down the bottom. We'll stop at the park. Get on the park path there. I'll put my gloves on, you can start the Strava.
Where are your gloves?
In my top there. Yeah, I'm fine. Go, 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 go. Right, we're going in through the gate, remember? Whew. Somebody shut the gate. That was a long, slow climb out of Bath on cold legs, wasn't it? And a stop at Lidl, yeah. Alright, here we go, first of the two tunnels. There's a runner, cyclist. Is your light pointing upwards? Is your light pointing upwards? No, don't do that. It's just the cyclist that came past was shielding his eyes. I wondered if it was pointing upwards. Might have been mine. That's quite a cool shadow on the wall though, isn't it? Cool shadow on the wall. They are. No, well, it's the long tunnel that has the noise, isn't it? The music. We'll get to that in a minute. No sounds at the moment. Oh, looks like we've got cyclists heading towards us. To be honest, it's not that dark in here, but you do have to just watch out for runners, which of course as pedestrians can go either side. And the occasional ninja cyclist with no lights, but actually it's not that dark in here, so you can really see in good time to be able to deal with stuff. And it's a lovely smooth surface. Now we've done the tunnels in both directions, and this way is definitely downhill, but the other way, I don't know if the wind blows up through the tunnel from behind, because it kind of felt downhill in the other direction as well, but anyway. Yeah, fantastic resource for cyclists. Because we're now in spring and had some good weather, I've changed to the dry lube on the chain, and we went for the muck off stuff because we'd heard, you know, it's good and there's reviews and that. And actually, when you first put it on, it is pretty good. If you put it on the night before you're going to use your bike, clean chain, everything, it's wonderful. But we found that after about 50 miles it needs replacing, so on a long journey you're probably better off choosing something else or taking some with you. Yeah, so if you get a coffee stop halfway through, just stick a bit on. Morning. But other than that, if you're commuting backwards and forwards, anything under about 50 miles, yeah, wonderful stuff. Really pleased with it. But we want to avoid the canal this time, don't we?
Yeah, I've got that.
Yeah, there's a riding school, isn't there, where this path ends?
Is there?
Yeah, and then we're back on the back roads to
Radstock.
Morning.
Another ghost station.
Yeah, we've done this, but we parked the car in Radstock and came up through here, didn't we, once?
Went through to Bristol.
No. Possibly, possibly not.
Cold legs.
Yeah, cold legs and heavy bikes.
I'm not heavy.
No, you're not. Yeah, back to the car.
That's nice of them.
Actually, we want to go that way because we want to go to Midsummer Norton. Not because we want to go via Midsummer Norton, but because that's where Halfords is. And I desperately need some new lubricant for the chain. Well, not desperately, but it's creaking a bit, so. No, we haven't got to the car park yet. Got on the pavement here. On the pavement. We're going straight across onto the greenway. Climbing out of Radstock on Route 24. Because I'm bound to forget where we are.
We've only done 22 kilometres.
That's alright.
That's not even Ferndown and back, is it?
That's one way to Ferndown.
suppose it does.
Hey?
I suppose it does when you don't know the route.
We did know the route though.
Well, the first bit we did, yeah. Okay. Morning.
Good morning.
It's because we keep stopping. Morning. Well, we stopped at Lidl and then we stopped.
Huh?
We stopped at Lidl. You would be at work now.
Huh?
You would be at work now. Does that help you start to enjoy it a bit more?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I want my legs to stop. You're going to say yours aren't even hurting.
They're not terrible. I'm aware of them. Certainly not hurting. I guess there'll be one at Frome. Yeah, yeah. I'll be there before you. Pretty much. Unless you're coming from the east of Southampton, Bournemouth's very difficult to get to by rail. Yeah, yeah.
Right, what did you say?
Unless you're coming from east of Southampton, Bournemouth's actually quite difficult to get to by train. Lots of changes. Yeah. Especially from this side of the country. In fact, you'd probably have to go back up. Back up to Bath. Possibly. Across to Basingstoke or Reading or Winchester possibly, I'm not sure. And then down. So I'd probably get home before you, even if you took the train. What Bournemouth is good for, of course, is commuting to London. Because you get to live by the seaside and you get to your office in London in 2 hours. Which is possibly not much longer than people sit in traffic to get to their office in London. So, yeah, jump on the train at Bournemouth, it's direct, isn't it? I don't know. It's still cold and damp. This is all uphill, of course.
No, it's flat. You've got a railway.
No, it's uphill. I can feel it. Plus, you've only had a banana this morning, so we'll look for some breakfast soon.
doing exactly
wonderful,
what I
thank
did
you.
On Sunday, take a picture of my picture of food, yeah.
Well, we're in Frome and we've stopped at Sainsbury's to have our breakfast for the day. We just had like a quick banana before we left Bath and we're now it's breakfast time. Is this second breakfast? I guess it is second breakfast, isn't it?
Because we had a banana.
Absolutely. So I've gone for the full English and Julie's gone for the smoked salmon and scrambled eggs.
No. That's what I said, look at the sign, because I wasn't sure. We could be turning left here though. Yeah. Turn left here.
Left.
Yeah, along here.
Surely going the wrong way.
I don't know. Google Maps is happy with our. But give it.
Surely going the wrong way.
Give it to. It's just getting us off the main road, Julie, that's all.
Feels like we're going back.
No. No. Yeah, it's just getting us off the main road. We gotta cross the road. And back to the tranquility of the English countryside. If only. If only.
I think I've got mud all over my glasses.
Yeah.
I think I have.
Well, you know, if you go tearing down these country lanes, that's going to happen. Train.
Car back.
Train.
Oh, it's a train. When we went under the railway there, I sign.
Yeah.
A green light.
Ah.
And I thought, oh, there's going to be a train across there in a minute.
And we missed it. Turning turtles. There was a sign, it said turning turtles.
Yes. Turning turtles.
A nursery school, do you think, or? This is true. But the guy in the bike shop was right.
Okay.
He did say have some wet lube because it's going to rain later.
And that's what you bought?
Yep. I would have done anyway.
Right, we're going to let this person come through.
Yeah, sure. Right. Ooh, bumpy, bumpy. Oh, follow it round to the left. Yeah, yeah. I don't think you can always take the turn that goes downhill. We might get lost that way.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
The horse and groom.
So anyway, we're at that's Longleat House, just there, and we came down to the top of the estate there, and it said strictly no access, authorised only, but actually it's part of Route 24, so we're able to go against the flow of traffic around the one-way system, but which is really helpful, and it was nice and wide, so I mean it was no problem at all to get through. So anyway, hopefully. Yes, and here's Ocado just delivering. So they've got the groceries in for the week. But anyway, hopefully we don't have to ride through the safari park, because I seem to remember when we went with the kids it was a bit scary. So yeah, well, it would be on a bike, let's say.
Yeah, I don't think we'll
need to. But anyway, next stop is probably Centre Parks and Warminster. Well, we'll skip Warminster, but we'll go past it. And then we're on our way down through Dorset towards Shillingstone. So yeah, we're not doing too bad. It's raining, but it's not terrible. Yeah, we're just fingers crossed it doesn't get any worse anyway. Ready?
Yep.
You sure?
I'm ready.
Okay, let's go.
on the way in. We must have gone down that way.
It's not like I ever keep a set of glasses for for more than a week or two, is it? Hello.
I'm steamed up.
Steamed up. You can't see anything. Pull it down your nose like an old schoolmistress, and then they... Straight across. Yep. Okay. This is the Wiltshire Cycleway. Watch out for the parked car, there's one coming the other way. Perfect timing. Yeah, here it is. That's why. Yeah, we're good.
Well, I'm glad he was where he was.
Absolutely. Absolutely. But he wasn't going fast or anything.
No.
He was being being sensible, wasn't he? Yeah. Which is good. Yes, he knew. He maybe saw us over the hedge actually. That's what I used to do when I drove the truck. You can see everything coming, pretty much. Oh, a bit of gravel. Hello, sheep. We're surrounded by sheep. We are surrounded by sheep. We're in the grounds of a house. I think it's Stourton House. But anyway, there is sheep everywhere. But they obviously let cyclists come through the grounds because it's part of Route 25. And traffic free, which is wonderful. Actually, one of the very few bits of gravel on the whole track. It has been mostly tarmac, which is nice. Where you go. Google Maps is taking a moment to catch up all the time. Again, under the bridge. Yeah, this is near Mere, isn't it? Yeah. You know what, I used to drive along that road all the time that we've just gone under, and I always used to think, oh, I wonder where that goes. Now I know. Car back. No, keep going. Not a lot we can do for the minute. With us, it's all single file, don't worry. Can't go much faster than we are, can he? Not down here. Keep going. Turned off. Feel like I need that right now. We found the defibrillator. So we must have come this way then.
Oh, we have come this way.
Yeah, I thought we'd turned up by Blackberry Birds, chickens for sale. Unless there's another sign for that further down. Anyway, I think we're okay. Yeah, and they. Say again, sorry?
Devlin's took up the pre-pack today.
Yeah?
So Ashley's out of the running.
That right.
Cost him 150 million quid.
Wow.
So I don't think he's too
What's that? What stopped? Oh, I see. That's typical, isn't it? Oh yeah, for sure. So keep the wits about you. Just say a bit enthusiastic. You can ease off down here because it's downhill. Go.
Yeah, must get in front. Yeah, another must get in front Audi. Right, we're going to turn right at the bank. That's it. Last climb back up to Ensbury Park and we're home. I mean, I hate to count my chickens and all that, but the bikes have been fantastic. They've carried everything comfortable. Fast when they've needed to be, light enough to climb even though they've been weighted down with all the gear. Just amazing. And these are just gravel bikes. Imagine what it'd be like if you had a proper touring bike. Anyway, this is the last climb, just up past the lights here. We turn off and we're home.